Number 10. Orcas are actually dolphins. Despite the fact that orcas are commonly referred to as killer whales, their actual biological classification is quite different. The name killer whale was given to the creatures by sailors who observed their behavior of targeting and killing actual whales in ferocious ways. They were initially called whale killers, however, over time, the name has flipped to what we know today. A lot of people get confused about the biological identity of orcas, mistaking them as shark species due to their appearance and hunting patterns, or whale species due to their confusing common name. Although orcas do fall within the loosely defined whale group, they are actually biologically classified as dolphins, with the Latin name Orcinus orca. They have black and white coloration, are toothed, and can be found in oceanic waters all around the world, save for the Arctic and Antarctic regions and the Black and Baltic Seas. They are carnivorous mammals, have an average lifespan of 50 to 80 years, and can grow between 23 to 32 feet, and can weigh as much as 13,000 pounds. That's at least half the length of a bus and at least a quarter its weight. Number 9. Orcas use a special sense to hunt. Orcas have developed a special adaptation that takes advantage of echolocation. Although echolocation, also called biosonar, is thought to be the forte of creatures such as bats, orcas, and other toothed dolphins have heightened senses in that capacity as well. They detect the location and characteristics of prey and other objects in the water by emitting clicks and listening for echoes. They have a special organ in their brain capable of transmitting three different waves for the best sensitivity. Number 8. Orcas have the second largest brains of any marine animal. Their brains can weigh as much as 15 pounds, which is half the weight of an entire Icelandic sheepdog. Although in the past, big brain size was thought to correlate with high intelligence, that isn't quite the case anymore, and orcas might be more intelligent than their pretty massive brain size suggests. Orcas are really high up on the list of intelligent creatures. However, you wouldn't know it just by judging the brain size. Brains are made up of different types of cells which all perform different functions. For example, sharks have a decent body-to-brain weight ratio, rivaling that of other mammals. But since a third of the brain is dedicated to olfactory acuity, the weight doesn't mean that much. And so, although orcas have a brain size that is 2.5 times larger than the average of other mammals, their cognitive abilities far exceed what is expected of them. They have really impressive social, cultural, and echolocation abilities. Number 7. Orcas are the second most widespread animal in the world. Killer whales tend to prefer higher latitudes and coastal areas over pelagic environments. The highest densities of these creatures occur in the Northeast Atlantic around the Norwegian coast, in the North Pacific along the Aleutian Islands, the Gulf of Alaska, and in the Southern Ocean off much of the coast of Antarctica. In these waters, one orca can be found per every 97 square miles. They also migrate quite a lot, although due to their low population numbers, their migration patterns are poorly understood. As recently as 2006, their numbers were estimated to be 50,000 worldwide, with 5,000 in the Antarctic, 8,500 in the tropical Pacific, about 2,700 off the cooler Northeast Pacific, about 1,500 off Norway, and about 2,300 in Japan. Although these figures are low, it's more likely that there's little information available rather than that these creatures are endangered. Number 6. Orca clans speak different languages. Orcas are highly social creatures that stick together to hunt, mate, protect one another, and migrate. They stick to small family groups called pods, which, when placed together, form larger societal groups known as clans. Orcas communicate with each other using sounds and non-verbal gestures. These include whistles, clicks, and loud broadband packets of sounds called burst pulses. Communication is used for warning each other of predators and prey. It can also be used to establish higher societal functions, which we will touch on in a little while. In any case, since the orca language isn't that developed, neither are the dialects. It would be best to think of them as different accents of the same language. These dialects differ from each other in much the same way as Australian accents, American accents, and British accents differ from each other. Nonetheless, their existence showcases the intelligence and higher social dynamics of these creatures. Number 5. Orcas go through menopause. The evolutionary purpose of menopause in humans is to protect both mothers and newborns. Births among older women are always difficult, with a high chance of miscarrying. However, for killer whales, the reasoning is quite different. Of their average lifespan of 50 to 80 years, males come into sexual maturity at 15 years old, while it takes 21 years for females. After mating and giving birth, the females go through menopause, living for long periods without sexual activity of any kind. This menopause occurs due to the habit of killer whales of staying in pods. Because both sons and daughters remain in the pod throughout adulthood, older females are increasingly related to everyone in the pod, and so they need to stop breeding lest they breed with their offspring and share genes, which will weaken the gene pool. Instead of doing this, females stick around and help by guiding and protecting young members of the pod. Number 4. Orcas have evolved based on culture. Evolution is one of the most basic laws of biology. At its most elementary level, it ensures that only living organisms with the best traits for surviving their environment can breed and pass these traits down to newer generations. In 2016, a team of researchers studied the genetic material of different orca groups. Lead scientist Andrew Foote and his colleagues discovered that genetic variations between different orca pods coincided with distinctions in culture and group social behaviors. To elaborate, this simply means that different orca pods hunt different types of prey in different ways, and these hunting patterns eventually led to observable differences between the genetic material of these pod groups. This is partially why different pod groups have different dialects. Number 3. Orcas are voracious eaters. Orcas eat just about anything, including fish, squid, marine birds, seals, sea lions, penguins, sea turtles, sharks, and even other kinds of whales. Their diet varies depending on the season, the ecotype of the orca, and their exact location. However, irrespective of these factors, the average killer whale can eat 500 pounds of food a day. To satiate this massive appetite, orcas tend to hunt in groups. It helps that they have no natural predators and can spend 60% of their time looking for food. The hunting groups tend to focus on vulnerable whales who are with children or separated from the group. A hunting exercise on this scale can take as much as 9 hours. First, they chase whales to exhaustion. Then they drown them by preventing them from resurfacing. Then they eat them. Number 2. Orcas exhibit sexual dimorphism. This means both males and females have different physical characteristics. These differences exist because males and females have different ways of life. Males need only to hunt and mate, but females need to perform the function of childbirth, child protection, and child rearing. While in most other marine species, females are larger to accommodate for these functions, that isn't the case with orcas. In fact, female orcas are smaller than orca males. Males typically range from 20 to 26 feet long and weigh in excess of 13,000 pounds. Females, on the other hand, range from 16 to 23 feet and weigh between 6,000 to 8,000 pounds. Males have an impressively tall dorsal fin, which can grow up to 6 feet long, compared to females, whose dorsal fins measure up to 31 inches. Other than that, most other features are the same, including the black and white coloration, blunt snout, and sharp teeth. Number 1. Orcas bully and eat sharks. Although great white sharks are thought to be apex predators, they get bullied and eaten quite often by orcas. Sometimes, after sharks go through the trouble of stalking prey, orcas show up and take the catch away from the sharks. In such situations, the sharks are happy merely to get away with their lives. As mentioned earlier, orcas are known to eat sharks from time to time. Killer whales hardly eat sharks unless they are having trouble finding less defensible prey. Because sharks aren't social creatures, orcas manage to take them down using the power of teamwork. In 2015, a charter operator known as Matt Waller observed with other divers in South Australia how a team of orcas took down a great white shark by repeatedly slamming into it. Two of the orcas were calves who were being taught how to hunt by their elders. Would you rather learn more about otters or sea snakes in our next education series? Let us know in the comments below.